towards the east, O Jerusalem, and see the glory that is coming from God. The night is far spent, and the day is at hand. Let us therefore cast off the works of darkness, and put on the armour of light. Come, O Lord, comfort the soul of your servant. O Lord Jesus, come. And in the morning with your glory. He who receives our prayers says, surely I come quickly. I am the root and offspring of David. I am the bright morning star. Welcome to this Advent carol service, in which the promise of God's light and life is told to us in music, in word, in prayer, and in silence. With all generations, we long for the coming of God's justice and peace in the world, in our lives. And so we pray, come, Lord Jesus.
Thank you. First reading is from Isaiah 41:7. But now thus says the Lord, He who created you, O Jacob, He who formed you, O Israel, do not fear, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name, you are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and through the rivers, they shall not overwhelm you. When you walk through fire, you shall not be burned, and the flame shall not consume you. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. I give Egypt as your ransom, Ethiopia and Sheba in exchange for you, because you are precious in my sight and honored and I love you. I give people in return for you, nations in exchange for your life. Do not fear, for I am with you. I will bring your offspring from the east, and from the west I will gather you. I will say to the north, give them up, and to the south, do not withhold. Bring my sons from far away, and my daughters from the end of the earth. Everyone who is called by my name, whom I created for my glory, whom I formed and made. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. They will be called oaks of righteousness, the planting of the Lord, to display his glory. For as the earth brings forth its fruits, and as the garden causes what is sown in it to spring up, so the Lord God will cause righteousness and praise to spring up before all the nations. Think this is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you, as with joy of harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness. From this time onward and forevermore, the zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. As we continue our journey through Isaiah's telling of the promises of God, we'll in a moment stand to sing the hymn, O Come, O Come, Emmanuel. After that, another antiphon, followed by our fourth reading, but incorrectly printed in this order of service. In fact, the fourth reading will be from Isaiah 60. Two. We stand to sing.
Thank you.
fourth reading is taken from Isaiah 62, verses 1 to 7 and 10 to 12. For Zion's sake, I will not keep silent, and for Jerusalem's sake, I will not rest, until her vindication shines out like the dawn, and her salvation like a burning torch. The nations shall see your vindication, and all the kings your glory. And you shall be called by a new name that the mouth of the Lord will give. You shall be crowned of beauty in the hand of the Lord, and a royal diadem in the hand of your God. You shall no more be termed forsaken, and your land shall no more be termed desolate. But you shall be called, my delight is in her, and your land married. For the Lord delights in you, and your land shall be married. For as a young man marries a young woman, so shall your builder marry you. And as the bridegroom rejoices over the bride, so shall your God rejoice over you. Upon your walls, O Jerusalem, I have posted sentinels. All day and all night they shall never be silent. You who remind the Lord, take no rest, and give him no rest, until he establishes Jerusalem and makes it renowned throughout the earth. Go through the gates, prepare the way for the people. Build up the highway, clear it of stones. Lift up an ensign over the peoples. The Lord has proclaimed the end of the earth. Say to daughter Zion, see, your salvation comes. His reward is with him, and his recompense before him. They shall be called the holy people, the redeemed of the Lord, and you shall be called sought out, a city not forsaken. For the word of the Lord.
Thank you.
O come, and be our God with us. O long-sought witness for a world without. O secret seed, O hidden spring of light. Come to us, wisdom. Come, unspoken name. Come, root and key, and king and holy flame. O quickened little wick, so tightly curled, be folded with us into time and place. Unfold for us the mystery of grace, and make a room of all this wounded world. O heart of heaven, beating in the earth, a tiny hope within our hopelessness, come to be born, to bear us to our birth, to touch a dying world with new-made hands, and make these rags of time our swaddling bands.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O wisdom coming forth from the Most High, filling all creation and reigning to the ends of the earth, come. Come and teach us the way of truth. Lord, in a world filled with lies, with hypocrisy, with short-sightedness, with words of fear and hostility, come. Come and teach us the way of truth. Shine on those who dwell in darkness and guide our feet into the paths of peace. O root of Jesse, standing as a sign among the nations, kings will keep silence before you, for whom the nations long. Come, come and save us and delay no longer. In a world where power is corrupted and unaccountable, we pray for your reign of peace and justice. Where the powerless feel the force of fear and uncertainty, come and reign in love. Come, come and save us and delay no longer. Shine on those who dwell in darkness and guide our feet in the paths of peace. O radiant dawn, splendor of eternal light, Son of justice, come. Come, shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death. For a world in fear, for creation in crisis, for all the darkness that seems to gather around us and beset us within, come with hope. Break in with joy. Kindle in us the light of your love. Come, come shine on us who dwell in darkness. O King of the nations, you alone can fulfill their desires, cornerstone binding all together. Come and save the creature you fashioned from the dust of the earth. In a divided world, teach us paths of unity. In a world where we are divided amongst ourselves, bind us together in peace. For a divided church in a broken world, teach us and show us again the paths of healing. Shine on those who dwell in darkness and guide our feet in the paths of peace. O Emmanuel, our King and Lawgiver, hope of the nations and their Saviour, come and save us, O Lord our God, in this season of longing. We pray that the dream of peace in the birth of your Son would be kindled in our hearts and in our world again. As the angels sang, glory to God in the highest heavens, and peace people on earth. May this peace dawn in us and among us, this Advent and always. Shine on those who dwell in darkness, and guide our feet in the paths of peace. In some moments of silence, we bring the prayers and longings of our own hearts, praying for God to come as we long for her presence. Shine on those who dwell in darkness, and guide our feet in the paths of peace. Thank you. do with God Rest Ye Merry Gentlemen and other favourites. Hope you can join us for that. Before that, at 3:30, Charlie Bell, priest and psychiatrist, is going to be talking about his book Queer Holiness here at St Paul's. So, also worth coming to, and there'll be, yes, you guessed it, mulled wine and mince pies available then as well. There are mulled wine. There are, there is. Mulled wine and mince pies are available after this service. We hope very much that you'll stay. On Friday the 7th of December, 9th of December, carol singing in our neighbouring Arlington Gardens. And then on the 13th of December, Tuesday evening, with more mulled wine and mince pies, student and community carol service. Come back for more and more. I think next year I'm tempted to have an early midnight mass as well, so the choir can sing Christmas Eve for us as well. We stand as we pray for God's blessing. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel, God with us. Christ, the Son of Righteousness, shine upon you, scatter the darkness from before your path, and make you ready to meet him when he comes in glory. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit rest upon you and remain with you this Advent and always. Amen.